Richard, baie keer in gewasproduksie hoor ons van die termen een baster en dan natuurlijk een oopbestuifde variëteit of een OBV. Wat is die verschil tussen hierdie twee termen?
Thanks, Gerrit. That's a really good question, and I think something that's not understood that well. So the easiest way to explain is to start with an open pollinated variety. So historically, when corn was first produced, it was open pollinated varieties that were used. These varieties really are kind of a mix of genes. You don't quite know exactly what you're going to get when you plant that exact seed. You see tall plants, small plants, some with big tassels, big ears, small ears. And basically what open pollinated means is that the variety pollinates itself. So you can keep seed back to plant in the following season. However, one of the disadvantages are that you don't see the types of yields that you would see on a commercial farm. The yields from open pollinated varieties really are quite low, actually.
So Richard, hoe verskil 'n baster dan van 'n OBV?
So the difference there is a hybrid variety is created by crossing two inbred lines. An inbred line is created by self-pollinating a maize plant, and in an inbred line you know exactly what the genetic makeup is of that line. It has the same copy of every gene at every locus. So when you cross two inbred lines, you end up with hybrid seed, which is what farmers in South Africa then plant. The benefits of a hybrid variety would be increased yield, better disease tolerance, and greater vigor when the plants are actually growing in the field. And because you know exactly what the genetic makeup is, you produce the same plant every time. The plants are genetically the same. And that's why when you drive around South Africa, you will see that within a maize field, every plant looks essentially identical.
So Richard, wat se boere plant basters aan en wat se boere plant dan hierdie OBV's aan?
So I think to start with open pollinated varieties, that's typically subsistence farmers in very rural areas that would have limited access to buying new seed each year. You know, they don't harvest that much, it's enough to feed their families, but they will keep back seed each year to plant in the coming season. In terms of hybrid varieties, that's typically commercial farming operations, so farmers that have the funds and the access to buy new hybrid seed each year, they really see the benefit of the increased yields, disease tolerance as mentioned, and there is a big drive within the agricultural sector to try and convert subsistence farmers who plant OPVs to planting hybrid varieties that would improve their farming.